Hello everyone, guys, my name is Amit Kumar Singh and I'm your master teacher with Dantu. And bacho, here we are going to have the discussion of the KVPY 2018 essay part 1 mathematics. So guys, what we are going to do, we are going to have a discussion on one of the very beautiful question. So let me just show you that. So bacho, just look out at the question, okay? It's a statement with the big statement, okay? So question says a solid hemisphere is attached to the top of a cylinder having the same radius as that of the cylinder, right? So if the height of the cylinder were doubled, keeping both the radii fixed, the volume of the entire system would have increased by 50%. By what percentage would the volume have increased if the radii of the sphere, if the radii of the hemisphere and the cylinder were doubled, keeping the height fixed? So the options over here are: option A is 300%, option B is like 400%, option C is 500%, option D is like 600%. So but you just have to understand the question, what exactly is happening over here, right? Initially, solid hemisphere is right there at the top of the cylinder. They are just manipulating height and radius, okay? And they're giving you the data. So let me just try to, you know, deal with this question, and just guys, stay with me. That's all you have to do. I'll take care of all the things, okay? So yeah, just have a look at this application. So guys, I've shown you the diagram also. I hope if you just try to see the first one, it is showing you that there is a cylinder on the top of that. If we are having a hemisphere also, and both the hemisphere and the cylinder are of the same radius. So yes, if you observe the first one, I hope it clearly gives you the feel that the radius and is that of the cylinder. So basically we are trying to project the original diagram in this case, in which if I try to talk that the radius of the hemisphere is like R and the height of the cylinder is H. So guys, if I want to write down the volume of this shape, you know, it is nothing but the volume of the, you know, cylinder plus volume of the hemisphere. So volume of the cylinder is going to be like pi r square h. I hope you can see the diagram, okay, the first one. And if you try to write down the volume of the hemisphere, it's going to be like 2 by 3 pi capital R cube. I hope all of you will agree, right? This is going to be the original volume. But if you try to double the height of the cylinder, keeping the radii fixed, guys, I hope what is going to happen to the volume? Okay, question is saying that volume of the entire system would have increased by 50%. So basically, if the initial volume was V and if you try to increase the whole volume by 50%, the new volume is going to be like 3V by 2. And this 3V by 2 is going to be equal to what? Guys, this corresponds to the second case, in which the height of the cylinder is 2H and the radius is R. That means that if I want to write down the volume, it will be like pi capital R square and then 2H plus volume of the hemisphere, guys, it is still 2 by 3 pi capital R cube. I hope all of you can see these expressions. Now, the only thing I'll say, guys, just because of this expression, I'm going to, you know, subtract 1 from the equation number 2. If you try to watch it very carefully, left hand side will be 3V by 2 minus V. It is going to give me V by 2. While on the right hand side, 2 by 3 pi R cube is going to get cancelled, and you are going to get, guys, pi R square h. So this is what I will get if I go ahead with second minus first. So this is what I'll get, right? Now once I have got this data, now I hope all of you can relate this information, and this information gives us that pi r square h is nothing but v by 2. So guys, if I put this value over here, I hope all of you will agree, if pi r square h is v by 2, so definitely 2 by 3 pi r cube is also equal to v by 2. I'm sure all of you can understand this point. Now my point is that wherever I'll need these two informations, now I'm going to utilize that. Okay, now this was the information that was given in the question. Now they're telling me, okay, if that is the case, can you tell me what is going to be the percentage change in the volume? Okay, percentage would the volume would have increased if radius of the hemisphere and the cylinder were doubled, keeping the height fixed. So I just want to ask you guys, let's just move on to the next, page. And if you just try to look at the scene, they're telling me that what is going to happen if I increase the radius from R to 2R, both of the hemisphere, solid hemisphere and the cylinder. If I just change the radius, keeping H as it is. So guys, can I say that if the new volume is going to be like V1, the new volume V1 is going to be like pi 2R whole square capital S, that is the volume of the hemisphere. Sorry, volume of the cylinder. And if I want to write down the volume of the hemisphere, it's going to be like, you know, 2 by 3 pi, you know, 2R whole cube. This is what I'll have. My point is that my only intention is to express this volume V1 in terms of V. For which I'm just going to take this 4 outside and it will become 4 times pi R square H. That's one thing. And plus 8 times if I take it outside, it will again be 2 by 3 times pi R cube. And bacho, I hope if you would have noticed the previous two results that I've just, you know, picked, that pi r square is nothing but v by 2 and 2 by 3 pi r cube is also v by 2. I'll just use these two relations and put it back over here. So I hope all of you can see v1 is coming out to be 4 by 4 v by 2 and plus 8 v by 2. The moment you'll try to simplify, v1 is coming out to be 6 times of v. So this is the change in the volume that you guys are going to have if you manipulate with the radius, keeping the height fixed. Now question is saying I want to see the percentage change in the volume, percentage increase in the volume. So what is going to be the percentage, you know, increase in the volume? So if you want to see this, my answer is going to be V1 minus V upon original volume into 100. This is what I do. If you try to put the value, guys, just watch it very carefully. V1 is like 6V minus V upon V into 100. On simplifying, guys, here I am getting like 500%. Now this is going to be my answer for this application. And guys, if you'll ask me which option is going to be the correct one, so guys, I hope all of you can see on the screen, the answer is 500%, which is option C. So bacho, I'm sure all of you would have understood this particular application. This was a simple application, but it requires a bit more calculation, but I'm sure all of you are pretty much comfortable. Okay, so guys, just stay tuned for the next one. We'll see you again. Thank you.